Now you'll want to sail somewhere rich with plunder.
Have you heard of a place called the Observatory?
Aye. It's an old legend, like El Dorado or the Fountain of Youth.
What have you heard?
It's meant to be a temple or a tomb, hiding a treasure of some kind.
That's it. See here.
Oh, rot. It's fairy stories you prefer to gold, is it?
It's worth more than gold, Thatch. 10,000 times above what we could pull off any Spanish ship.
Robbing the king to pay his paupers is how we earn our keep here, lad. It ain't a fortune. It's a fantasy.
Why, look! It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet 10 times the demon his father was.
Thank you, man.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before.
Huh.
So, what's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that'd earn you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands, and he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him. And he'll lead you straight to your prize.
Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous, and free, and out of the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the Brethren of the Coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
Truth. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, can we? It's a story for schoolboys. I mean proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. Make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir.
Then I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
Kid. Wake up, Kenway.
What's that about?
He left this morning with the galleon. As faith, we'll discover a good use for this old cove ourselves.
Aye, we'll make something of it in time. We could keep a fleet here if we like. And with a bit of fixing up, it'd be a decent place to call home. Might even convince my wife to come one day.
You're married, are you?
In God's eyes, I am. She left me some time ago.
Even so, keep that fact hid away. Most of these pirates don't respect a man with higher commitments than rum and plunder.
Upon mine honor, let me know if you find anything.
Odd-looking things, aren't they? Old and weathered.
Is this what they call Mayan? Or is it Aztec?
Are you good with riddles, Edward? Puzzles and ponderings and the like.
No worse than the next man, why?
I think you've a natural gift for it. The way you think and work. The way you understand the world.
Well, I don't know about that. You're talking in riddles now and I don't understand a word.
Clamber on top of this thing here, will you? Help me solve something. Concentrate and focus all your senses. Look past shadow and sound, deep into matter, until you see and hear a kind of shimmering.
A shimmering?
You understand?
I think so. I've seen its like before, glowing like moonlight on the ocean.
Ah, right, I know this feeling. I have since I was a lad. It's like using every sense at once, isn't it? To see sounds and hear shapes. Quite a combination.
Every man and woman on this earth has in them a kind of intuition hidden deep away.
I've had this sense most of my life. Only I thought it was related in some way to my dreaming or the like.
Most never find it. Others, it takes years to tease out. But for a rare few, it comes as natural as breathing. What you feel is the light of life, of living things past and present. The residue of vitality, come and gone. Any man's senses can be tuned well past what he's born with, if he tries. You are a gifted man, Edward.
Has a strange look. Is it worth something?
Nothing you can spend. But if you find all of them, it'll lead to something grand.
How many?
A few dozen, I think. This way. I've something else to show you. I found something else just here. I think you'll take to this secret much faster.
Now this has the makings of a mystery.
It's good, isn't it? Only wait till you see what lies at the end. Here we are. What do you think?
I think Monsieur Ducasse was a man of many secrets.
Aye, and look here. A solid staircase leading God knows where. What do you suppose lies at the top?
From what I knew of Ducasse, I wouldn't be surprised to find eclectic instruments of torture and villainy. An Iron Maiden or a collection of thumbscrews.
Or a pair of anguish.
Not a nice way to kick off. But that is some damn fine gear.
Try the key you took from Ducasse.
That's one. Only four left.
Aye. It might be that these four Templars have them. See the names here? They've been sent to kill these four targets.
Hang me, that's the map I sold to Governor Torres in Havana. He said it marked the location of assassin encampments.
You think maybe you owe them a bit of warning, then? If you have any kind of heart beating in that chest.
Suppose I could. If it leads me to the four other keys.
Bad excuse is better than none at all.
Leaving already?
I think this cove suits you best, Edward. Better than that costume does.
Oh, come on now. We're pirates, kid. We take as we please and become who we like. Self-made men.
But that look ain't you. It's not who you are.
Who am I, then?
Hard to tell some days. All I know is you like dangerous prizes.
Like the observatory. I think you know more about that than you let on in NASA.
You noticed that, did you? Meet me at 20 degrees, 3 minutes latitude, just off the coast of Yucatan. I'll have something to show you there in a few weeks' time.
Something. I can feel it.
Captain Kenway? What is the assassin, Duncan Walpole?
Dead and buried. After he tried to kill me.
We are not sorry to see him gone. But it was you who carried out his final betrayal. Why?
Money was my only aim.
Should I find comfort in that? You murdered our brothers and sisters in Havana.
He has the sense, Mentor.
James tells me you treated with the Templars there. Did you see the man they called the Sage?
Aye.
Would you recognize his face if you saw it again?
I reckon so.
I must be certain.
Not a word. Come on.
You walked me blind and backwards into this mess, kid. Who the hell was that jester back there?
Atabai. An assassin. And my mentor.
So you're all part of some daffy religion?
We're assassins and we follow a creed, aye. But it does not command us to act or submit. Only to be wise.
Oh, do tell. I'd love to hear it.
Nothing is true. Everything is permitted. This is the world's only certainty.
Everything is permitted. I like the sound of that. Thinking what I like and acting how I please.
You parrot the words, but you do not understand.
Don't get haughty with me, kid. I followed you as a friend, and you tricked me.
I saved your skin bringing you here, man. These men wanted you dead for what you did in Havana. I talked them out of it.
Well, cheers for that.
Aye. Cheers.
So it's you lot them Templars have been chasing, then?
Until you came along and mucked things up, it was us chasing them. We had them running scared. They have the upper hand now.
Must be a great treasure beyond.
Treasure? Right.
Whatever's waiting at the end of this path had better be worth my time.
That'll depend on you.
How's that?
What I'm taking you to see may spin your head right round. I only hope you can take the shock of it.
I can handle myself. Is this it, then? The grand prize your mentor asked me to see looks nothing like the man they called the Sage, I'm sorry to say.
Keep your trousers tied up. With one more riddle to solve.
Jesus, that's him, the Sage. But this thing must be hundreds of years old.
Older still. You're certain it's him?
Aye. It's the eyes that mark him.
Did the Templars say why they wanted this Sage?
They drew some of his blood into this small glass cube.
Like this one?
Aye. They meant to ask him about the observatory too, but he escaped.
Huh. We're finished here. Quiet.
The statue in the temple. Was that the man you saw in Havana?
Spitting likeness, aye.
It seems another Sage has been found. The race for the observatory begins anew.
Is that why we're whispering?
This is your doing, Captain Kenway. The maps you sold to the Templars have led them straight to us. And now the agents of two empires know exactly where we operate.
Leave this to me, Mentor.
They have taken Edward's crew as well. I wonder what their lives are worth to him.
Take this. You'll attract no attention, and take fewer lives.
Who's out there?
See that mangy old codger? He's a Dutch slaver called Lawrence Prinz, living now like a king in Jamaica. Bastard's been a target for years. Bloody hell, we nearly had him.
By God, you bravos are a cheery bunch, eh? All frowns and furrowed brows.
Captain Kenway, you have remarkable skills.
Thanks, mate. It comes natural.
But you're churlish and arrogant, prancing around in a uniform that you have not earned.
Everything is permitted. Isn't that your motto?
I absolve you of your errors in Havana and elsewhere. But you are not welcome here.
Sorry, mate. Wish it were otherwise.
Cheery bunch of mates you've got.
You deserve scorn, Edward. Prancing about like one of us, bringing shame to our cause.
And what is that? Your cause?
To be blunt, we kill people. Templars and their associates. Folks who'd like to control all the empires on Earth. Claiming it's in the name of peace and order.
Sounds like Decass's dying words.
You see? It's about power, really. About lording over people. Robbing us of liberty.
That another message from one of your friends?
Aye. I'll show you. I know you ain't exactly impressed by our creed. So would the sight of money make you more friendly to our ways?
As ever.
Then work these contracts around the West Indies for us, and we'll pay you. As simple as that. Now follow on. I have one last secret to share.
How long have you been one of these assassins, eh?
Couple years now. I met Atabai in Spanish Town. And there was something about him I trusted. Sort of wisdom.
Is all this his idea? His clan?
No, sir. Assassins and Templars have been at war for thousands of years. All over the world. The natives of this new world had a philosophy like our creed for as long as they've been here. And when Europeans arrived, our group sort of matched up. Cultures and religions and languages keep folks divided. But there's something in the Assassin's Creed that crosses all boundaries. A fondness for life and liberty.
Sounds a bit like Nassau, no?
Close, but not quite. Here we are. Take that stone you discovered from the Mayan Stella and put it there. That's one. Couple dozen more and you're in.
What will this effort gain me?
Respect for a start. From the men and women you put in danger here. And if that ain't enough, there's a treasure behind that door. Something many centuries old. I reckon if you made the effort to find every last one of those, it'd be worth your while.
So are you sailing back to Nassau?
When I have another contract there, right? But this is my home for now.
Here's how it goes. Torres meets with Prince, carrying a portion of the ransom, saying the rest is close behind. When we see the Sage, you bring in the rest of the gold, make the swap, and get out. I'll be watching all from close by.
No, Kemmer, you run this scheme alone, at the risk of losing the faith of your crew. It makes me ill to think of you bartering with that wretched slaver.
Come on, mate. Once we have the Sage, we'll all be rich.
Not if young Master Kid gets to him first.
Kid? Jesus. That lad's here to kill him.
Edward! What the hell are you doing here?
I'm tailing these men to the Sage. And you hold off till he appears.
The Sage is here?
Aye. And Prince is leading us straight to him.
All right, Jesus. I'll stay my blade for a time, but not long.
Ah, see. Much has changed in that short time, you know. None call me governor, for instance, for I quit that post last year.
You couldn't help it, could you, Ken?
Ah, I was not aware.
You can't understand.
You're making me nervous, kid. Keep your blades corked.
Just my bloody... Now's the time!
No! Not until we see the Sage.
Here's a quiet spot. I'll see the money.
This is a portion of the ransom. The rest is close at hand.
It pains me to traffic someone of my own race for profit, Mr. Torres. Tell me again, what has this Roberts fellow done to upset you?
Is this some form of Protestant piety I'm not familiar with?
Perhaps another day.
What?
Next time, see to it that we are not followed. Deal with this!
You cocked up my kill, Kenway.
For a better cause.
You lost your chance, man. I'm going after Prinz.
Kid, no! Jim, stop!
Damn you, old strat! Keep your natty hands off me!
I can't let you kill those men, kid. Not until I found the Sage.
I've been stalking that pig for a week now, charting his moves, and here I find not one but two of my targets, and you rob me of both.
Patience, man. You have your kills.
When I locate the Sage, you're helping me take Prinz. Got that!
Wouldn't you prefer meeting in a pub?
I came to Kingston chasing a target. Getting pissed ain't a priority.
We could work together on this, you know. It's Lawrence Prince you're after. I want his prisoner.
We're after the Sage as well, Edward. Careful who you cross.
May the best man win.
There's guards patrolling that property from end to end. Looks to me like they use bells to signal trouble. See there? We'll want to disable those before pushing too far. With so many men about, we can't rely on stealth alone, so I'll do what I can to distract and draw their attention, giving you a chance to cut them down. Ready?
Your name's not James, is it?
Not most days. Come on. If you see Prinz before I do, kill him, and there'll be a bit of coin in it for you. All right?
Damn, man. How is it you're a woman?
Christ, Edward. Is that something that needs explaining? Now, I'm here to do a job. I'll let you be amused later.
Hold! Stand your ground!
Please. I've been shot. I need aid.
Christ, Thompson, look at her. She's hurt.
Dreadfully, sir. I'm poorly.
All right.
I'm faint.
Take an arm, lass.
Bless you, lads. I found your man!
I remember you. The Templar from Havana.
I'm no Templar, mate. That was just a ruse. We've come here to save your ass from this slaver.
Save me? I work for Mr. Prinz.
Well, then he's a poor man to call master. He meant to sell you out to the Templars.
Oh, you can't trust anyone, it seems.
Roberts!
Lost your man again, did you?
Aye. Roberts is a devil with a queer aversion to kindness. I suppose that's two men I've lost today. So, what's your real name, lass?
Mary Reed to my mum. And them I call friends. But not a word of it to anyone. Or I'll unman you as well.
Oh. kid. You missed quite a time.
Aye. Pity about Nassau and Blackbeard flying the coop.
Well, we'll see about Thatch.
Vane's off to see him now, and I'm following soon.
This is what's left of your experiment in democracy.
Aye. We do as we please here, and we take our time doing it.
But for Christ's sake, Edward, don't anything but the stink of riches wrinkle your nose.
What's got into you, man?
Reality, mate. Reality. See that you ain't pulled into the drink by this drowning rat.
Oi! I've lived longer than most men who trod this path.
Stealing a fishing schooner single-handed. Damn canny, Captain.
As is taking back my break from this pillock. Once again, I thank you both.
This Billy Huff didn't last 2 months with your ship before he came limping back to Nassau. Took the pardon straight away.
I had to, lads. That Rogers was onto me from the first.
Hold your tongue, Rackham.
So what now? Still chasing your elusive fortune?
Aye, and I'm close. I've heard the Sage is sailing out of Kingston on a ship called the Princess.
Put your ambition to better use, Kenway. Find the Sage with us.
I've no stomach for you and your mystics, Mary. I want a taste of the good life. An easy life.
No one honest has an easy life, Edward. And it's aching for one that causes the most pain. All right, Rackham. Back to retirement.
This is bloody witchcraft.
No. This is Mr. Jack Rackham, somewhere in the world at this moment.
Nassau? Well, this is happening right now. We're seeing through his eyes.
I don't know, Jim. I haven't the faintest idea how to pilot a ship. That ain't work a woman does.
Tosh! I've seen a score of ladies who can reef a sail and spin a capstan.
And would you teach me to fight? With a cock glass, like? And maybe handle a pistol?
All that and more. But you have to want it and work for it. There's no stumbling into true success.
Oi! Lad! That's my lasso making love to. You lay off, or I'll catch ya.
Up your arse, Rackham. Lad's the last thing you should be calling me.
Oh, is that right, is it? Lad?
The charges, sir, I'll hear them again.
My lord. His Majesty's court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage, and take 7 certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take 2 certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway. Born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother. Married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastards, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay, for a time. But this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck, till you are severally dead, dead, dead!
Oh, Ross!
May God in his infinite mercy be merciful to each of your souls!
We're pregnant! Do you all hear that?
What the devil did she say?
They plead their bellies, my lord.
Aye, you can't hang a woman quick with child, can ye?
Quiet! Quiet! If what you claim is true, then your executions will be stayed, but only until your terms are up.
Then I'll be up the duff the next time you come knocking.
Remove them!
Mary? Mary, it's me, Edward.
Edward? Who's this fella?
It's all right, Anne. He's a friend. What's wrong with Mary?
She's ill.
And her child?
They took her. No idea where. Oh!
Oh! Oh! I know it begs, my lady, but we must be silent. Can you walk? Lean on me, Mary. Come on.
I can't.
Search every cell!
Come on, that's it.
You're all right.
Stop. Stop, please.
I ain't leaving you, damn it. Lift your arm.
It's no good.
There's no one here!
I ain't leaving you nowhere. No bloody way.
Put me down, Edward. Don't die on my account. Go.
This is such a pain in the ass. Damn it. You should have been the one to outlast me.
I've done my part. Will you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary.
I'll be with you, can we? To Mary. What's wrong?
Is she gone?
Oh, no.
Oh, God! Oh!
What will you do now?
Nothing sensible.
You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you, Edward Kenway.